Welcome to Chemical Engineering Tutorials. This channel discusses various interesting topics in the field of chemical engineering and other supporting fields of science. This opportunity, we will discuss about modeling the activated sludge process with sludge recirculation. The activated sludge process for wastewater treatment utilizes the services of aerobic microorganisms to degrade organic compounds present in wastewater. In general, the activated sludge process for wastewater treatment consists of two main equipment, namely an aeration tank and a sedimentation tank. In the aeration tank, aerobic microbes are developed by utilizing oxygen and organic compounds used for microbial metabolism. Aerobic microbes will degrade organic compounds in wastewater to produce carbon dioxide, water, new cell biomass, new compounds resulting from cell metabolism, and energy. During the treatment process, as a result, the substrate concentration will decrease until the desired output concentration target is obtained, and the microbial concentration will increase. The liquid mixture from the aeration tank is then put into a sedimentation tank to separate the clear liquid from the processing with the output substrate concentration and the microbial sludge with a certain concentration as well. This microbial sludge is called activated sludge. The sediment from the bottom of the sedimentation tank contains a high concentration of microbes, which is then recirculated into the aeration tank. A portion of the sludge is also discharged to the sludge treatment unit to prevent accumulation of sludge solids, and also to adjust the residence time of microbial cells. To explain in more detail about the process that occurs, the activated sludge process modeling is used. In more detail, it can be explained as follows. Wastewater with volumetric flow rate Q0, initial microbial concentration X0, and initial substrate concentration S0, enters the aeration tank with volume V. In the aeration tank, which previously developed aerobic microbes, microbes with the help of oxygen from the air will utilize the substrate from wastewater to meet metabolic needs in microbial cells. Therefore, the substrate concentration will decrease from S0 to S, and the microbial concentration will increase from X0 to X. The liquid mixture from the aeration tank then flow into a sedimentation tank to separate the clear liquid from the processing and the substrate concentration S, with microbial sludge with a concentration of XE. This microbial sludge is called activated sludge. The sediment from the bottom of the sedimentation tank contains a high concentration of microbes XW, which is then recirculated back into the aeration tank. A portion of the sludge with volumetric rate QW, sludge concentration XW, is also discharged to the sludge treatment unit to prevent accumulation of sludge solids, and also to adjust the residence time of microbial cells. Furthermore, the cell mass balance and substrate mass balance is arranged to study the mechanism that occurs during processing. In general, the equation for cell balance and substrate balance is as follows. Accumulation equals feed input plus recycle input minus output plus formation by reaction. The substrate mass balance is as follows. VdS per dt equals Q0S0 plus WRS minus Q0 plus QR times S minus K0SXV divided by Y times KM plus S. Cell mass balance. VdX per dt equals Q0X0 plus QRXR minus Q0 plus QR times X plus K0SXV divided by KM plus S minus KDXV. If it is defined that the recycle ratio R is equal to QR per Q0, and the residence time of the theta feed is equal to V per Q0, the following balance equation can be drawn up. dS per dt equals 1 per theta times S0 minus S minus K0 Sx per Y times Km plus S. dx per dt equals 1 per theta times x0 plus rx r minus 1 plus r times x plus k0 sx per km plus s minus k dx. In steady state conditions, where dx per dt is equal to 0, and ds per dt is equal to 0, the equation can be changed as follows. S0 minus S minus K0 Sx theta divided by Y times Km plus S equals 0. X0 plus Rx R minus 1 plus R times X plus K0 Sx theta per Km plus S minus K dx theta equals 0. If it is assumed that there are no microbes in the wastewater feed, then X0 is equal to 0, the balance can be rearranged become Rx r minus 1 plus r times x, plus k0 sx theta per km plus s, minus k dx theta equals 0. If the reactor is also operating where the microbes are in the growth phase, then the endogenous respiration can be neglected, or kd is equal to 0, the mass balance of the biomass becomes Rx r minus 1 plus r times x plus k0 sx theta per km plus s equals 0. Biological reactors, in general, produce excess biological solids, which must be separated from the system during steady state operation. The quantity of excess biomass formed is equal to the net growth of biomass in the reactor, which is equal to K0 SXV divided by KM plus S minus KDXV. It is this excess biomass, which usually has to be removed from the separator or sedimentation tank. In a sewage treatment plant, these solids are sent to some type of sludge treatment process. Furthermore, two operational parameters, which are widely used in the design and operation of biological treatment systems, are the process loading factor, U, and cell residence time, or average biological solids, residence time, theta m. The process loading factor is the mass of substrate consumed over a certain period of time, usually days, by the mass of microorganisms in the reactor. The process loading factor U can be described by the following formula. U equals K0SVX divided by Y times Km plus S, divided by 15 equals K0S divided by Y times Km plus S. The magnitude of U is also referred to as the rate of removal of the substrate or food to microorganism ratio. Another common parameter is the mean solids residence time. The mean solids residence time, theta m, is the ratio of the amount of solids in the bioreactor to the sum of the biomass synthesis rate and the fresh feed solids input. The amount of biological solids in the bioreactor equals the concentration of biological solids, x times the volume of the bioreactor V. The rate of solids entering the fresh feed is equal to x0 times q0. The rate of biomass synthesis is equal to K0SXV divided by Km plus S. So that the average residence time of the cell, theta m, is equal to XV divided by X0Q0 plus K0SXV divided by Km plus S. Under steady state conditions, the denominator of the above equation equals the rate at which biomass is lost from the system through outflow and endogenous respiration. Theta m equals xv divided by qwxr plus qexe minus kdxv. Where qw equals the waste flow rate of the recycle flow, qe equals the overflow rate of the clarifier, xe is the concentration of biomass at the output or the overflow of the clarifier. In general, the cell mean residence time has not been widely used, because the value of Kd is often unknown for wastewater influence. Instead, the term sludge age has been used, which is defined as the ratio of the biomass in the reactor to the net rate of biomass generation. Theta C equals XV divided by K0 SXV per Km plus S minus KdXV, equals Km plus S divided by K0S minus Kd times Km plus S. From equation 10, where U is equal to K0S divided by Y times Km plus S. Furthermore, the age of the theta C sludge can be controlled by the rate of removal of the biomass, as in equation 15. If the kinetic constant is known, assigning one of the quantities S, U or theta C determines the other two. At steady state conditions, the net rate of biomass generation is equal to the rate at which biomass flows out of the system. If the biomass is removed by discharge in the recycle stream and lost in the clarifier overflow, the sludge age is given by equation 1 per theta C equals Y U minus KD. Equations 10 and 14 can be solved to get S as follows. S equals Km plus Km Kd theta C per K0 theta C minus Kd theta C minus 1. From the above equation, it can be seen that the concentration of the treated waste substrate S at various residence times of certain cells can be determined if the constants K0, Km, Kd are known. From this equation, it can also be seen that, in activated sludge treatment with sludge recirculation, the concentration of the treated substrate is not affected by the residence time of the liquid, but is affected by the residence time of the theta C cells. The next problem is how to determine the constants K0, Km, Kd. Since the sludge age removes the endogenous part from the denominator, the sludge age will be greater than the mean solid's residence time. However, the ease of application of equation 17 for the operation of the treatment plant encourages the use of aged sludge. Sludge age has an important impact on the sedimentation characteristics of the biomass, and will be discussed further in this session. If the kinetic constant is known, the assignment of one of the quantities S, U, or theta C determines the other two. At steady state conditions, the net rate of biomass generation is equal to the rate at which biomass flows out of the system. If the biomass is removed by discharge in the recycle stream and lost in the clarifier overflow, the sludge age is given by equation theta C equals XV divided by QWXR plus QEXE. Thus, the age of the sludge can be controlled by the rate of removal of the biomass. Since the sludge age removes the endogenous part from the denominator, the sludge age will be greater than the mean solid's residence time. However, the ease of application of EQ 17 for the operation of the treatment plant encourages the use of aged sludge. Sludge age has an important impact on the sedimentation characteristics of the biomass. The following is the literature that can be used as material for further reading. Thank you.